send you out here.
What you getting now?
I'll pay for your ticket to come out here. I'll pay for your ticket to come out here, and we can do this debate live in person. And I guarantee you, you won't have that energy in person. I guarantee you. And I had another man talk crazy just like you, but in person, he wasn't speaking that crazy. It was a entirely different story.
It's a entirely different story.
Yeah. Now, I have a question. Now that you had brought up the hermaphrodite thing, just because I had saw a documentary on this, and it was really sad. But do you think if one of your children were born as a hermaphrodite, that you would make the decision to raise them as one or the other? Like, how would you handle that? Because the documentary was, these people were born as hermaphrodites and the parents made the decision as to what sex they wanted the child to be. But then when the child grew up and the hormones and everything started coming in, they actually felt that they were the opposite. Mm. So it was like they wanted a little girl, so they raised her as a girl. But then that hormone, when they hit a certain age, came in, and
so let me get you straight. That means you got the egg and you can lay the seed.
Typically they can't get pregnant.
They usually don't work.
Brittany, what's that? Brittany Griner, she like that.
What?
I remember they.
That was a rumor. I think it was just a rumor.
When I first talked, I'm like, damn, her voice deep.
Hey, but y'all remember when they said Sierra was a hermaphrodite?
No, I remember she had nudes and all that. So,
wait, answer me though. What would y'all do?
She had a huge camera pad. That's what it was.
I don't even know how to answer that question, man.
I would.
What's the question?
As a parent, I don't know if I would be okay.
I mean, I'd be mad if I want to make a decision and then they make a decision. Or I started looking at mannerisms or something like that. It might be determined, like maybe.
But it's like, what age though? Because kids, when they're younger, you know, they're playful. Like, you know, they're kind of, it's inconclusive, like you just don't know.
Yeah. I'd be getting I'd be trying to put like He-Man in his hands, and he keep trying to pick up Barbie dolls. Like, look, the decision has been made already.
No, I don't think they're that old, yeah.
I just gotta it's one of those situations. You let them choose.
Gender conforming makes sense.
Wait, you said let them choose, Darwin?
Yeah, I mean, you just gotta
choose if you want to be a girl or a boy. So,
you just gotta do a test. Okay, put something in front of them. If they get hard, they gonna be a girl. If they get wet, then they'll be a girl.
Oh God!
I mean, think about it. You don't want to say as a boy and all the jokes. All the
boys.
We crossed the line.
Toys and girl toys.
Hold on, wait.
Allow them to play with both until.
I'm just saying. Listen, they're defaulting to the alphabet. Quick,
well, hold on. I thought y'all said only.
I agree, Chris. Just let it be.
I thought y'all said only one of them work.
Huh?
Usually one of them work.
No, I was saying that.
I haven't seen any cases where
they can't get pregnant. Then they're a boy by default.
No, because
what if they can't impregnate someone either?
Set them up for depression and stress. Oh, I can't have babies. That's a terrible situation for a boy to be. I mean, never mind.
For them,
this is a confusing conversation.
All right, I'm sorry I derailed the conversation, but that just popped into my head when she brought up the hermaphrodite. I apologize.
You took us down a river, Miss Peyton.
Yeah. I don't even heard that word in
San Francisco.
I haven't heard the word in so long.
Could we consider dude to be a metrosexual? Because it looked like
this was killing me. This
metrosexual means you dress like
order, right? Men create order. This is my platform. Natural.
Against his mother, so instead of being a protector, the son became the predator, and then Christianity.
Oh,
on.
But where you at?
I have you on, bro.
Smash the shit out. So
listen, actually, here's what I'll do for you, because I've been waiting for someone like you.
Yeah, I'm right here.
I'll send you out here. I'll send you out here.
What you getting now?
I'll pay for your ticket to come out here. I'll pay for your ticket to come out here, and we can do this debate live in person. And I guarantee you, you won't have that energy in person. I guarantee you. And I had another man talk crazy just like you, but in person, he wasn't speaking that crazy. It was a entirely different story.
Bro, you can tell everybody it was a entirely different story. You a bitch, man. Everybody in the room can see you a little hoe, bro.
You now you're making ad hominems. No one made ad hominems about you. This nigga looking like a fake Drake over here, man. This nigga looking sweet as cheese. How you over here trying to act hard when you get your eyebrows done every day? This nigga looking sweet.
Hey,
this nigga sweet as pie. Put that little chain on. Nigga squinching his eyes. Nigga, what's in your eye? Why you keep squinching your eyes like that? Trying to have the light skin look. Come on, bro. Calm down with all that, nigga. Let's have a regular discussion. You making ad hominem attacks. I make none on you. You made them first. So we can either finish this debate.
Through the whole white boy, bro.
This guy said a white boy. Just because you can't articulate yourself. Just because you can't articulate yourself. Doesn't mean that I'm a white boy because I can. That don't mean that, nigga. Chat is clowning you right now. But anyways, bro, here's what I'm saying, man. Everything that you said is all false because the root of it, the cause of it is false. The man is superior than a woman. Why doesn't a matriarchy
ever stood a test of time? It's just been hijacked by the patriarchy. You women still produce us.
How
can you just chill for a minute? Can you give me a little bit so I can talk to people to get them to understand why
it ain't going like that. That isn't how this goes, bro. Because you're not answering questions, bro.
I'm tired of your questions. Just let me speak.
Listen, man, if you're tired of the questions, then you can hop off the stream, bro. You're just speaking nonsense right now.
You're getting frustrated. Like I said, you're intimidated. For you not to let me talk. But I'm over here.
Nigga,
really
you look like a broke Drake, nigga. Who intimidated
you? You said that already.
No, no one said broke. That was different. Yeah, okay. See, you can't listen. You don't have good active listening skills, buddy.
Shit,
you don't have good active listening skills. Low IQ.
You got a man wig on.
Low IQ,
man. And you talking about Drake, man.
This nigga said a man wig, bro. My hair is just long, man. It's just
okay, well, line that shit
hair,
up.
Bro.
Line your shit up.
Yeah,
line your shit up.
Good.
You see that shit?
Look at Whack your headline, buddy.
You sitting there. Look at it. It's lined up, nigga.
Now,
what the
your
fuck
junk
is
crooked.
Your
jaw leaning over here,
bro.
All
right, bro. All right.
Your jaw tilted.
That's what we get.
Anyways, so
intimidation.
Like I
that
said,
is
there's a hierarchy. You started the ad hominems. I didn't start the ad hominems.
You don't want me to speak.
But here's what it is. It's a hierarchy to things. So if you don't
want
to follow the orders, you can hop
off
the stream or I'll
kick
you off the stream.
No, I don't understand. Man, you're a bitch anyway, nigga. You didn't want to do nothing anyway. You got your ass murdered over here.
You believe that 1+1 doesn't equal 2.
You call it whatever.
And
you
I've already
the
said, we
questions.
Could have this live stream in person. And I trust you in person, you wouldn't have this energy. I'll literally fly you out.
I'll come out.
I'll bring you out here, bro.
I'm not your little
Listen,
boy. I'm not
I'll
your little
bring
toy.
You out here.
You're talking.
I'll bring
You're
you out
just
here.
Talking. We're talking.
Do you take
on
my offer? I actually offer you. So this is what men do. This is what men do. Because let's see if you're really man of your word. Men are men of their word. So here's my word. Here's my word. I'll fly you out here and we can have this debate in person. I put it on my word. If you really want to come out here, I'll fly you out here and we can do it in person. And after that, we could box. How about that? Let's do it. If you really feeling froggy, nigga, leap. I'll send you out here. I'll put that on my word. Hundreds of people in here. No. You want to approve to that offer? If not, then shut up, nigga, and pay attention to the hierarchy. Here's the rules. So I'm going to ask you questions, and then you're going to listen, and you're going to answer these questions. Because you're just talking just to talk. The patriarchy. He's speaking.
Hey, dude.
You wanted to run the feed.
Hey, and he had to think about it too. He was like, "Man, I'll fly you out."
It was entertaining. I give it that.
Hey, but Viz, you see, you caught what he said, right? With the habit of what black people who don't articulate themselves well, and they see someone else do it, they associate them with white. Sort of like what we had on that One King talk.
That's the point I was trying to make.
But everybody was trying
That's what I was saying.
Now, what I'm saying, I'm like, bro, just because you have some type of education, it doesn't mean you're white. Other races can be educated and not educated. Education and articulating yourself in a professional manner or even a way where people can better understand you, that isn't about race.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that is just foolishness, and that's why I called it out. Like, man, we can't do that because this clown now thinks because this man can articulate himself in a certain manner and use big words that he white. It's like, come on, man, grow up.
And then you see what came next. The curse words came right after that. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was just.
I mean, you know, that's what she produced, and that's what he's spewing out. And so when you get further into the conversation, you realize that his ideology is flawed. Because a man taught you to have a conversation with another. That's why he went to the, all right, well, let me just fly you out here and we're just going to catch the fade. Because that's what two men do when they can't really, when you coming at him so aggressively and he's just trying to have a conversation with you. It's like, okay, we're done with the rules.
Let's take this outside.
Where your mouth is, right. Man would have been able to teach him, hey, look, this is how you have a respectable conversation with another man. You get your ideas, you get your points, you get everything together so you're on point.
That's why I like when JR used to have the in-person podcast, because when he was having it, a lot of people didn't have that type of energy, because they knew at one point everybody's gonna buy tickets and go be together. Exactly. Hey. So you really gotta be on that shit whenever somebody come in your proximity.
And that's what I said earlier. You know, a lot of people they get behind the screen, and you tough titty, but in person,
it's a tough titty.
You know what I'm saying?
I hear that in years.
I never heard that.
Yeah, no, that's old. I got an old school nigga.
Tough titty. That's like some new shit.
You ain't never heard tough titty. That usually means like
for my time,
like tough shit.
Tough titty is luck.
You
trying to get some milk out of that motherfucker, but she ain't gonna do it.